Okay, this is the Black Knight 2. It's an improvement over the original Black Knight. I restructured a few things and improved a few things. There's more weight in the front. The wings are more, a little more reinforced. Has a larger wing area. Overall, you could probably get about 20 or 30 feet improvement in performance. But the most important thing is the stability. And the consistency of the plane is improved quite a bit. You could probably get around maybe 250, 260 on a really, really good day. You could use this Conqueror paper. It's pretty good. It's a little more stable, but it's kind of makes the plane a little poofy, and it's slightly lighter than the paper I use normally, which is this. It's really good paper. It's slightly heavier than regular 100 GSM. It's a little bit heavier than the Conqueror paper. So after that, let's get started. You only need to lightly crease these folds right here. I'm going to keep that bottom corner folded. You just fold the paper to that corner. And you fold this corner to that corner. Make sure you have both of the diagonals creased. It's easy to miss that step. So what you want to do here is just leave just a little bit of a space. The thickness of the paper will kind of naturally already fold that way, but you want to leave a little bit of a gap right there. So it's kind of the same thing. You want them to be the same distance. So just pop that out. You still want to preserve that little gap right there. So from that little gap that you made, you want to fold right there to that corner. There's going to be a little bit of space right there. This helps stop the nose from tearing. So what you want to do is you take this edge, you fold it over from that little point down here. So we're folding from that space, not the corner, but the space here. So just like with the other version of the Black Knight, you want to fold this down and leave a little bit of space right there. This is a judgment fold, so whatever works for you. That's slightly different from the other version of the Black Knight. So instead of folding this over and then folding it, I just put both folds into one. You want to crease that little area good. So now you want to fold this up. And it's just like the other version of the Black Knight where you fold this angle in the thirds. Usually right about there, good enough. Pull this into thirds here. Realistically, you want to do this first and keep it folded in thirds because it helps keep everything compact. Thank you. So what this is doing is this is further reinforcing the leading edge of the wing. And that's going to help increase stability and performance. This is something else that's different from the other versions. You want to fold these in all the way. One of the other differences the Black Knight 2 has. So what you want to do here is you want to fold from the space, the corner of the space, and you want the outer edge of the wing to have about the same space as the top and the bottom. So that's going to increase the wing area a little bit, and it's going to make the plane a little more stable. Like that. Everything matched up nice and symmetrical. Be kind of tricky, but it can be done. You don't necessarily want it to fold right up to the very edge. You still want to give a little bit of space because you have to deal with the thickness of the paper. And we're just going to fold over in 1/4. Kind of tight here. want to bring this out, but you want to keep everything perpendicular down here. And you'll leave a little bit of a space. Like that. Just want to fold these under. It can be a little difficult because of the thickness of the paper. Just go and reinforce all the creases. Fold in half while keeping pressure on here so it doesn't come completely unfolded. Same old locking mechanism as the other version of the Black Knight. what you want to do here, roll it up a little bit. You don't have to go the whole way. You want to fold from that little line there to back there. And while you're doing that, you can kind of see how the wings want to contort. So you can just kind of bend it to keep the wings straight. And just go ahead and crease it pretty good. You want to kind of keep the wings as straight as you possibly can get them. You don't want bent wings with this plane. So now you just open this out. And just smooth that off. So you want to give it a little bit of air lines. A little bit, and like I said before, when you're balancing this plane, you basically just do that, barely touch it. You basically want to visualize the edge of the paper instead of bending the whole piece. You just kind of want to manipulate the trailing edges, the trailing fibers of the paper to balance it. So if it's kind of leaning off when it's flying, so you want to, you know, barely touch it like that. And when you're throwing it, you want to kind of visualize and make a conscious effort to keep the keel straight at all times when you're throwing it. That'll help you, you know, make it more stable. So that's it. Enjoy.